Well, hello everyone, and it's Huey, and we're back for some more Baldur's Gate 3 in our Adventures of Arnigul, Fallensong, Half-Orc Bard series. And, in the last episode, we were exploring the Cursed Shadowlands, and we were about to encounter an ambush, I think it was Karlak who spotted it. So, yeah, we're going to hit the ground running, so to speak. And we'll see how we go. But yeah, we had a few encounters in the last one. We did spend a lot of time exploring. I've still got this glitch with Will with the warning over his head. Yeah, but I wanna examine these guys. So level 5 measles. They have 68 hit points each, and they are ambushing. They're very quick. AC of 14. Detailed view. I will say they do have hair that looks like me in the morning, but alright, well, let's see what we can do. Let's see how I go. Even though I'm a little bit injured, let's see how we do. They're spotted. Alright, no, they can see us.
Keep going.
They're still surprised, though. Jeez. Yeah, that's what I thought. So it is a bonus action. Target is too far. Not enough space. Alright, I'll have to take some shots from here. That's okay. And I might as well use some healing word on Arnigul. Oh, one hit point. Thank you. Better than kicking the teeth, I suppose.
Push my luck again.
I'll run over here.
Keep going.
All right, you go invisible. Not much for you to do, except let's send you over there.
Can't afford to let up. When I go.
We'll go Guiding Bolt. Haven't used that one in a while. Do I need to upcast it? Oh, damn it. All right, well. Ooh, do we want to? Don't want to group them too much, so.
Fleet of foot.
Let's hit the O key. Could hit him, but it's a disadvantage, okay. Target is too far. I guess we'll do that. Okay. Garrotted, I guess I'll just hit him then. Mobile flourish, defensive flourish. So I got a disadvantage there for some reason. I'm gonna take it anyway. Okay. Yeah, bash him with a torch. Why not?
Say bye bye.
Reckless time. Oh, beautiful. Get him to jump. I can't do much, so I'll just. He doesn't have very much movement, so. No, I am not gonna do Sunbeam, but. Let's hit you with that. Sucks.
No time to waste.
Let's do this. Hit him again. Oh, really?
Let's go.
I'm gonna dash.
I've got it.
Healing potion. Another heal. Another Eldritch Blast, or... No, let's do that. On him.
These boots have seen everything. All right, Karlak, it's go time.
Bash him.
This.
level again. Yep. Bolt. Who needs healing? It's to Karlak. That was a good one.
Finding my way.
All right, that was quite the battle.
Let's get going.
A little bit more difficult than I thought it would be.
Something good here, I hope.
Alright, send a camp. They got a thing for choking people, apparently. I really did dig that that combat music though. Measle, right. Alright, I think we should use a short rest. Yep. There's a potter's chest up there. I'm gonna jump up there alone because I don't want Karlak like getting stuck again. Lockpick. So it's a difficulty class of 14. So let's see how we go. Oh wow. New luminous gloves, radiant. Oh, and we found another idol of Saluna. Okay, radiating orb gloves. When the wearer deals radiant damage, receive one turn of radiating orb. Affected entity has -1 to attack rolls per turn. Her remaining turn, it also sheds bright light in the area surrounding it. It could be very good for Shadowheart. So what's the notes say? Mood Maiden, protect those of us who would not turn from you, no matter the consequence in this short life. Keep these artifacts of our devotion until such time as we may openly infuse our spirits with your white light once more. Grant cunning to my brother, Halfred, in his efforts to conceal the rest of your relics. Let the name Last Light not be portent. Let your moon glow continue forever and fill our hearts. Okay. Investigate the Salunite resistance. I hit J and it just disappeared. Thanks. Alright. Okay. Still took a hit point, really? Well, whatever. Anyway. I want to see if... What gloves? Shadow... Gloves of the Growling Underdog. Oh, yeah. Excuse me, folks. Yeah, I'm going to change that to the Luminous Gloves. Because she's going to love that. I won't tell her that they're Salunite gloves. But, yeah. Because we deal a lot of radiant damage, so I'll give those to her. I'm sure she'll love it.
What's hiding here?
Alright. So the good news is, also, we can sell a lot of the magic items we don't need anymore, because Gale's not going to be consuming them, as far as I know. So let's see how far we can push this. What did I spot? I spotted something. Oh, a tripwire. I guess we better not go in there then. I don't think there's... Oh, can I disarm it? I can try. Okay. I'll just go guidance. No, you know what? May as well cast Cat's Grace. May as well. We would have got it anyway, but still. So we've got a note here. Harper interrogation transcript. Official interrogation transcript. Harper in charge. Calado Everspring. Transcriber. Luna Sean. So CE. Your name. DT. Dull. Dull Timber, ma'am. CE. Occupation. DT. Farmer, ma'am. Potatoes. CE. A farmer. How many guards is Thorm stationed at the south wall, Dull Timber? DT. What do you mean, south wall? CE. Do not play fool with me, Timber. The Moonrise south wall. DT. I don't know. I swear it. CE. Liar! Pause. Write this down, Luna. Thorm Spire refuses to cooperate. Harsher measures required. Pause. I said, write it down! Stained towel? Dagger? Whoa, what is the, what have the Harpers been up to? Holy shit. Jesus. Oh, I found a traveler's chest and some black oleander. Oh. Grab that. We'll lockpick that. Yeah, we'll grab the guidance again. Ooh. Well, now I'm glad I used Cat's Grace. Twilight. Again, plus one bonus to armor class while obscured. Nice. Could be good for a Starion. So, this is very rickety. Wooden crate. Nope. That's very ominous. Why did we get experience?
The dark's strong here. This torch is useless.
All right, let's not. Let's not go that way then. I was wondering about that. Exit. Okay. Well. I did get a bunch of XP for that though. Very nice. see a chest up there, but could also be an encounter. Oh, I heard something. Dead Githyanki. They're not having a good time of things at the moment, are they? Glad Lazel's not here. She'd be quite upset. Ugh. What have we got in here? Oh, yeah. Yeah, so what's been going on here? So we can't pass there.
There's a darkness to these warriors that endures even now, long after their lives were spent. Who did they serve?
Me, now. Inscribed Githyanki Slate. So that's Karlak. Let's have a read. A map has been etched onto this intricate disc. The Risen Road winds through a mountain pass. Within the hills is nestled a sizable temple. Within the temple, the Githyanki people have established a stronghold. Pictographs reveal their mission: to retrieve a polyhedric relic on behalf of the Githyanki Queen. Well, I already knew that. But some people might not. Alright, so what's down here? Chest, Traveler's Chest. I'll grab that. let's go ahead and add guidance. We may as well. Oof. Locked too. Well, let's lock pick it. Alright, let's see what we got. The Gloom Strand Shield. Gives stealth plus one. Okay. Take that. Those are handy as well. So what other parts of the map do we still need to explore? So we've got infiltrate Moonrise Towers, we've got follow the convoy, summon the guide. Oh, investigate the Selenite resistance. Okay. I think we should do that. We continue to explore some more. Oh. So maybe.
Made it ready.
Corpse too damaged. Okay.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
So I need to take this stone disc. No. You don't need to take that. Oh yeah, I like this. Yeah, that'll help.
Slow down.
Wait, what? Oh, okay. I must have misclicked it twice or something. Oh, no, we go this way. Alright, we'll go this way. We go up here. Back to where we were ambushed. Okay. Dead guy. This is all very, very creepy. Shadow Mastiff is there. So we need to keep going up that way. Okay. Alright. Here goes nothing. so I guess we'll go through here. Yeah, I remember Icaron was one of the guards at the, one of the guys walking around, at least, the Druid Grove. We can't go that way, obviously. Dead raven.
That dead bird's been corrupted by the shadows. Would be wise to leave it alone.
Very well. We do have some charming little eggs. Let's examine. 3 camp supplies. Why not? Another traveler's chest. Might separate myself briefly before I do this, though.
Wish I had a bag of holding.
Now, what have we got over here?
Wonder what's past this.
Gold, better than a kick in the teeth, as I always say. Alright. Got another traveler's chest down there. Let's regroup. Oh, destitute clothes, thank you. some wooden barrels over here. We should probably check it. Oh, hello.
Stay together. Keep to the light.
Escape lunatic. Let's go to the bard.
I find the best introductions are made while sitting around a fire, perhaps with drinks.
You're a chatty shadow. I'll give you that. Come out into the light, hands high. Move in!
anything! Something's wrong!
Follow my voice! Come back to the light!
Who's there? Meg? Is that...
Let's try to save them, I guess. I don't have Pommel Strike, though, so I can't knock them out. Depend on them. Hope they die. No. Yeah.
Harpers! Two arms!
Oh, the shadow. Right. Okay.
Nothing will stand in my way.
Shadow cursed undead. All right, we need to hopefully try and take out the shadows. They're gonna be, let's examine those. They're gonna be quite tough. So, slashing, piercing, bludgeoning resistance, acid resistance, thunder resistance, necrotic resistance, lightning, fire, cold, poison, and is susceptible to radiant damage. So, I think that's our best opportunity. Ethereal, effective. Entity is incorporated, can't be shoved, thrown, or used as an improvised weapon. Okay. Shadow blend, and lightly or heavily obscure this creature. Gains the ability to blend with shadows and become invisible. Alright. Okay, so there's no point in using fear, I don't think. Can't use sleep. Did it have resistance to psychic damage, actually? It did not. Right. Dissonant whispers it is. I think we should go bless. Yeah. Up to five creatures. Oh, okay. Maybe not. Let's go guiding bolt then. Oh wow.
Gods, it's hot in here.
Okay, Karlak. So we have a branding smite, which I'm gonna try. And we missed. Try again. That hurt it. Oh, Oh wow, there's a lot of them. Okay then. So Eldritch Blast is force damage, okay. Let's go there. Spirit Guardian's time. It's like that. Wait. Can I... Am I still garroted? Huh? Can't cast spells. Garroted. Double miss. That sucks. Oh, well. We couldn't save him. Vestige, okay.
Light on my feet.
Somewhere over there, is he? Screw it. Still one somewhere, I don't know where though.
Coming through.
dude. Oh, so we got the play. Oh, that's how we end it. Okay. I have to make sure he's alright.
Let's finish this. Got to move.
Okay.
Heating up. Find a route.
Somewhere up there.
Coming through.
I can still dash. Should. Can I firebolt this? No. So I'll dash.
But to keep going.
Sure, I'll follow them. In fact, actually, I'm going to end this. Dash.
I wonder if the gods are watching me.
Oh. Okay.
My turn.
Yeah, dash. She can run quite a long way. That high strength really does serve her well. As well as being a barbarian.
Well done. Now we've got to move. I know a safe place. Give me your map. Keep your torch high. If you step into the shadows, you'll be felled in a heartbeat.
Safe place? You mean somewhere the shadows can't penetrate?
That's right. Protected by magic. Only spot in the region that's not been swallowed up by this damn curse. Light will save you here on the outskirts, but a few paces deeper, you're screwed. If you want to catch your breath, the inn's the only place to do it. Hope to see you there. Harpers, move out!
Harpers, as in, there's one other. Check. Let's have a look at this.
You see a man stalking slowly through the woods, bow half drawn. If he bags a deer, the whole family will be kept fed all winter.
Interesting. So we can't. Shadow root sack. Yep. Let's get that. So these each tell a story. That's
the
very sad.
The image of an orange-haired cat asleep before a fireplace comes to you. What came of it?
Wow.
You see a man stalking slowly through the woods, bow half drawn. You sense a young woman gazing at moonrise towers in awe. Perhaps one day she will get to gaze out from atop it, she hopes.
Here we go.
In her former life, this girl played in the nearby woods. She was always the best at climbing trees.
So, that was quite the encounter.
You see an older woman on her knees scrubbing the floor of an inn. The patrons made a mess of things again the night before.
Let's light the brazier. Be like, I don't know. Little beacons. But before we sign off for this episode,
defender of the people.
Yes, yes. Just see what you can find out from these people.
The corpse has nothing to say.
Okay. Well, what about this guy?
The corpse has nothing to say.
Oh boy. All right. Well,
is that blood?
If there's nothing to say, oh wait, no, there's another thing there. Let's have a look. Cursed.
He had dreams of boarding a ship in Baldur's Gate and seeing the world. But then the darkness came.
Swift as my feet can carry me.
Well, that does suck, but I think we'll leave it there, folks. So thank you so much for joining us. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, consider dropping a like. It really helps the channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell notification if you want to get notified of any videos that drop. I think they drop at 7 p.m. Actually, I know they drop at 7 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time every day. That's UTC plus 10 for all you international folk. And don't forget, leave a comment. Love to hear from you. But that's all from me. And until next time, take it easy. And bye for now.